Hi, Heather here, owner of Acorn Health and Wellness. I am kicking off this Friday, March 15th, with a new series. I just completed last week a series called Create a Lifetime of Happiness, where I shared several different tips on how to keep that positive living, that positive mindset, because we can never have enough positivity, right? Like, there's no way to measure that. And so from that, as this has been born, a new series that Embracing the Detours, like a healing journey of love, really learning to love the life you did not choose, learning to create a healthy relationship with yourself so that you can heal those inner wounds, those emotional wounds that really stay with us for the rest of our life. And when we have these blockages, when we have this trauma going on, and that emotional interior and exterior, it is a cause, it's linked to all these adult onset diseases, like those heart diseases, thyroid problems, diabetes, and really just always feeling disconnected in those depressive states. So this is a series focused on loving the life you did not choose, embracing your detours, so that you can heal and live that happy, healthy, strong life while being connected to those you love and really embracing your happiness. Because the more of you that's there, the happier you're going to be. So welcome, welcome. Today I am talking about understanding our expectations. And what I want to do before we start, comment and like if you are joining me. If you're watching the replay, please comment and like this video. Always love to know who's joining me, what Acorn friends I have around. All right. Just as in the 30 video series for Create a Lifetime of Happiness, I'm always going to start off with a quote. And so the quote of the week comes from Thomas Dewar. Minds are like parachutes. They only function when open. I love this one. Minds are like parachutes. They only function when open. Yes. We cannot function when we are closed off, when we are disconnected. Because when we become closed off and disconnected, our cravings increase, that emotional eating increases, our anxiety, our depression, all those things go up. And the more connected we are, the more fulfillment we have, the more we are embracing the natural world around us. We are made of nature, so we better go ahead, get outside and enjoy it. Be part of what makes us. And we can't heal when our mind is closed off. You have to open your mind. You have to open your heart in order to connect to yourself. And the more you can connect to yourself, the more you can be in that present moment, the more you can connect with others and have those healthy relationships with all the people that you love, all the people you encounter each day. And what I really love about thinking of it as a parachute that does not function when it's closed, the same way our body does not function when we are closed off. And a good thing to do is when we can open our heart, open our mind, that allows this openness to the others that surround us, and we can learn from others. And maybe we learn something profound that's gonna help us heal, that's gonna help us grow, help us transform. Or maybe we learn something and okay, we just learned something new about someone and that creates that bond, that nourishes that bond, and then we just move on. So always bringing that openness to everything that we have throughout the day. Fantastic. Let me know, how do you feel about that? Do you agree? Do you notice any differences in your day, your moods when you're closed off versus when you have an open, engaging heart? Comment, share with me, let me know. All right, let's get into today's topic, understanding our expectations. Who has expectations here? Yes, they are this prone, a pattern of ours. It, by definition, an expectation is a strong belief. A strong belief that something will happen or be the cause of something in the future. And usually our expectations dictate whether something's going to be good or whether something's going to be bad. And if we're going into something with the expectation that something's going to be bad, we're creating all this worry, all this anxiousness before something even occurs. So we're going into it, we're thinking it's bad. So then we're loading up on all this negative feeling beforehand. We're doing our body harm before something's even occurred. And if we go into it with really high, like, oh, this is going to be the best thing ever. Oh my God, I love this. I'm so excited about this. And then once the experience is unfolding, we have such a high expectation that we're let down afterwards. We're let down. We're kind of feel defeated and depleted after that experience has unfolded completely. And so then we're just either living in a state of negativity before or negativity after, and not really being present and enjoying anything. So what we need to do to move away from that when we're having these good and bad expectation, we kind of stay in this compare and despair mode where we're always measuring how things should or shouldn't be, living in the shoulds, the coulds. And if we're always measuring, it's never going to be enough because you can't measure enough, right? And so when you want to really move from that compare and despair into a restore and repair mindset by understanding your expectations. And when you move away from that compare and despair, where you're always measuring things by good or bad or how something should or shouldn't be, you do get to go into this rest and healing state. And that's where your health is going to thrive. That is where your energy is going to increase and your fulfillment is going to really be felt from within. And the way that I want to share with you guys is through an exercise. And this is just really getting to know your expectations. So I'm going to go through this exercise and it has about seven different questions that you can go through. This really helps you understand your expectation and put reality and expectation, make these parts work together so that you can move forward, get feedback from that, and move forward in a more empowering and healthy way. So, getting to know our expectations, understanding our expectations. Question number one: what is the current situation that turned out differently than you imagined? What was the exact outcome? So, what is the current situation that turned out differently than you had imagined, and what was the outcome? It doesn't have to be a bad thing, it can be a good thing, or it could be something that is bad, whatever one you want to choose. I'm going to give an example of marriage. So, for me, my marriage was something that I imagined all these things would be, right? And the outcome ended up being a really damaged first few years and a lot of trauma and betrayal right out the gate. And now I'm in a state where it's a healthy thing. We have healthy boundaries, healthy communications, and we're separated, but in a healthy, loving way. So that was my expectation of having this marriage, of it being something so great and grand and going to be my key to happiness, to it was a lot of betrayal and trauma at the very beginning. And the feelings, the next question, what feelings, what sensations go along with that outcome? And for me, there was a lot of failure and sadness and disappointment when I thought of marriage and what I thought the outcome should be. And third question, what are, if anything at all, are you making this experience mean about you? So my marriage experience, what I was making it about me was that I'm a failure. I'm not enough because my marriage started out that way. That means something's wrong with me, right? And the next question, what was my expectation of my marriage? What was my expectation for this situation? And mine was, I expected us to grow together and be in this honeymoon phase, right? Everybody talks about this honeymoon phase after you first get married, where you're all lovey-dovey, like you're the greatest thing to one another. And that was my expectation. Like once we got there, then the relationship issues that were existing before would be so much better. Oh my gosh, they're just gonna magically go away, right? And the next thing I want you guys to analyze is, was this expectation clearly articulated to all involved? Was this clearly communicated to all involved what was expected for the current outcome? No, it wasn't. It was not, like with my own personal situation, like I just went into it with blind faith, like, oh, love conquers all. That's all I need to know. I'm good. And push down all those wants I was feeling, all those, doubts and worries, instead of talking it out and communicating what I expected, what he expected. We didn't talk about it. We just were like, oh, well, we love each other. This is the next step. Marriage is great, right? All right, next question. Is this expectation your own? Or did you pick it up somewhere else earlier in your life? So is this expectation your own? Or was it created earlier in life? And for my example, it was created earlier in life. Like watching movies, Disney, hello. That was always like the point, the ending, right? Like the relationship build might have gone through some chaos, some struggles, some obstacles. And then at the end, happy relationship. You ended up together. That was the end. That was the end point. There wasn't anything further. Like once you got there, like all happiness was received, right? So there's that expectation there. And also that seeing little glimpses from my friend's parents who were still together and seeing this happy couple that were married and not knowing any of the struggles, It's like, oh, okay, they're married, they're happy. Oh, that's the end goal. All right, next question. What was the positive intention of that expectation? What was the positive intention of that expectation? So the positive intention of that expectation of mine was, okay, like once I reach that status of commitment, then I will truly be connected to my partner. Once I'm truly connected and I find the one, I have happiness. That was the intention. Like I wanted love. I wanted to belong. That was my intention. All right. Now that I've uncovered my reality, the expectation, where it all came from, what I was making it mean, now the last question is, now that I know all this stuff, how do I want to move forward? Now that you've gone through that series, how do you want to move forward? Now you understand it a little bit more. So we have feedback, we have knowledge, we have information, and now we can reflect from that, what we learned, and move forward. So for myself in that example, I got to take time to nourish those connections. I got to have the hard conversations. No matter what the outcome might be, I got to speak what's in my heart to nourish my connections. I got to have that communication. I have to trust in myself that what I'm feeling is right and that I need to address it and bring it to light instead of shoving it down, 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 down. So that is how I chose to move forward from that situation and the outcome. Thank you guys for joining. That was the first episode of Embracing the Detours, a healing journey of love. And today's topic, I was talking about understanding expectations. And share with me, you guys, what type of expectations do you have? Do you notice that when you're thinking of an experience or an event coming up, are you having all sorts of expectations, good, bad, in between? Or are you just being present and seeing how it goes? Thank you guys for joining. I so love sharing this with you guys. If you like this video, please comment, like, or share this with someone you know that could benefit from this. It is my mission as a coach to aid in personal transformation so that we can heal our emotional wounds and have healthy, lasting relationships once and for all with all those people in our life. Really embrace the life we are living and loving it no matter what is going on, spreading more positivity, spreading more love, because in my opinion, you can never get enough. If that is something that interests you, please feel free to reach out to me if you have any questions. I'm always happy to chat or put interested in the comments and I will get in touch with you. Thank you for joining and I will be back next week, Friday, 12:30, same channel. Where I will be talking about water consumption and how that is so important for our mood health and what it does for our mental health, emotional well-being. Thank you guys. I hope you have a great weekend. Bye.